Audible Inc. presents Collaborate, The Art of We, written by Dan Sanker, narrated by Brian Troxell. Forward. As far as we know, this is the first book forward to be written as a collaborative effort, possibly proving that Tom Clancy was wrong when he said, collaboration on a book is the ultimate unnatural act. An audiobook forward is usually an introductory section in which a prominent person discusses the author, the audiobook, and the topic. From this audiobook's title alone, a reader can infer that the author, Dan Sanker, believes that the prominence of any individual is dwarfed by the prominence of the group. As a result, he has used a creative approach, asking people who he believes have helped him become a better practitioner of the art of collaboration to collaboratively write the audiobook's foreword. It was something of an example of what folks in the technology industry refer to as dog fooding, meaning eating your own dog food, as when a company actually uses the products that it makes. Other more elegant people have referred to it as ice creaming or drinking your own champagne. Regardless, the team's goal was to collaboratively deliver a foreword that discussed the usual topics that publishers in the industry suggest. The author's qualifications for writing this audiobook, the special contributions the audiobook makes to the field, the listeners who will be interested in the audiobook and why, the ultimate significance of the audiobook. Instead of the foreword being written by a great big muckety-muck, it has been developed in collaboration by a team using a wiki that the author popped up in about 10 minutes. It seems that most of us started with a somewhat negative impression of the highfalutin concept of collaboration. We thought of many examples of times when we were part of insincere corporate efforts that started with the notion of empowerment. Some of these seemed more like phony empowerment. Workplace participation can mean a lot of things, but regrettably, the promise of democratic involvement in the workplace is all too often a disguise for the same old authoritarian institutional structures. Very few organizations actually allow associates to really shape meaningful matters of policy. As a result, employees who are promised participatory opportunities usually become disenchanted. The concept is great, an alternative to the dehumanizing concept of the division of labor, wherein workers or individuals are treated like robots. But it has to go beyond giving lip service to the idea and be real. Many people have seen their companies or organizations invest in the latest and greatest in collaboration gadgets and gizmos, but most still feel that nobody is getting much from collaboration efforts. There are tales of investment, rollouts, training, upgrading, meetings, and more to achieve the nirvana promised by the collaborative model. There are anecdotes about costly investments in Microsoft SharePoint servers and IBM QuickPlace applications that, at the end of the process, usually becomes solely the province of a select group of technorati. It's all enough to give the word collaboration a bad rep, along the lines of, we tried that once, but it seemed like waste of time. We've also seen collaborative exercises that do seem to generate some results, only to end up with some of the worst collaborators getting involved and derailing progress. On the flip side, we all have this inherent sense that collaboration is one important key to innovation in the world we are currently living in. Throughout history, we see the big, bodacious ideas coming from collaborative efforts. Any business leaders who use historical references as a guidepost for their own personal and professional development can easily see how collaboration has shaped our world. History does tend to repeat itself. For example, we considered some of the world's most influential people and found elements of collaboration almost everywhere that something actually worked. Would America exist as we know it without the Federalist Papers, which were created in collaboration among, as generally attributed, Alexander Hamilton, James Madison, and John Jay? The Federalist Papers are a series of 85 articles or essays promoting the ratification of the United States Constitution, without which the structure of America's founding papers would be substantially different. Collaboration is the basis for much of the foundational arts and sciences. It is often speculated that Shakespeare, like most playwrights of his period, did not always write alone, and many of his plays are considered collaborative or were revised after their original composition. Leonardo da Vinci made his sketches individually, but he collaborated with other people to flesh out the finer details. For example, his sketches of human anatomy were a collaboration with Marc Antonio della Torre, an anatomist from the University of Pavia. Their collaboration is important because it marries the artist with the scientist. Similarly, Marie Curie's husband stopped his original research and joined Marie in hers. They went on to collaboratively discover radium, which overturned established ideas in physics and chemistry. In the world of business, Jack Welch practiced collaboration at GE, championing the usefulness of constructive disagreement in reaching creative decisions. He had inherited a culture of what he called superficial congeniality, in which people didn't tell each other the truth. Like Andy Grove at Intel, Welch recognized that conflict was inevitable in dealing with novel and complex decisions, and that conflicting views contained information that needed to be harvested and incorporated into decisions. Before Grove and Welch, Lee Iacocca collaborated with designer Michael Leone and the Gafoglio family of metal crafters to customize what became known as Iacocca Silver Mustangs. Using the same collaborative methodologies, Iacocca headed the Statue of Liberty Ellis Island Foundation, which raised funds to renovate and preserve the Statue of Liberty. Lou Gerstner is credited with turning IBM around in the 1990s. He described the turnaround as difficult and often wrenching for an IBM culture that had become insular and balkanized. He moved the culture in a more collaborative direction. The company is currently home to over 426,000 employees, with revenues approaching $100 billion and assets exceeding $113 billion. It is arguable whether IBM would still exist without Gerstner's collaborative changes. Some have said that Oprah Winfrey may be the world's most powerful woman, but she didn't do it on her own. She has worked in collaboration on innumerable projects over her career. Oprah's Angel Network has raised over $80 million to improve access to education, protect basic rights, create communities of support, and empower people to become leaders. Even Nelson Mandela, himself an incredible collaboration champion, praised Winfrey for overcoming her disadvantaged youth to become a benefactor for others. Rosa Parks is known for her act of defiance that became an important symbol of the modern civil rights movement. She collaborated with civil rights leaders, including Martin Luther King Jr., helping launch him to national prominence. Without the collaborative beginnings of the civil rights movement, our society might not look anything like it does today. Then there are the dramatic innovations that we all use every day. For example, many of you will be listening to this audiobook on a device that wouldn't exist without an early collaboration between Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak. Wozniak's engineering talent and Jobs' ingenuity and marketing instincts started it all. Even the group writing this foreword used tools that wouldn't exist if Mark Zuckerberg hadn't formed the now controversial collaboration with a few other important contributors in the early days of Facebook. And it is likely that none of us can go for long without using a search engine created in collaboration between Sergey Brin and Larry Page. Dan's book opens the door for everyone to become an innovator. Dan introduces an idea that is much needed and will have a ripple effect in today's economic climate. Collaboration will help entrepreneurs get started, increase innovative technology, and help cut rising costs for everyone in the supply chain. The audiobook allows listeners to see every industry as a part of a whole. When two or more businesses put their cutthroat competitive ideals aside and come together, they can create new markets that could not have existed before. Today's global economy is getting ever faster, and the way business is conducted must be as efficient as possible. This audiobook is timely because collaboration is no longer just a good idea. It is absolutely essential for businesses to thrive and grow in this time of economic survival of the fittest. Each chapter helps take collaboration from a nice word to a powerful growth strategy. In a most entertaining and persuasive fashion, Dan exposes the false choice between being a shrewd competitor and a community builder. This audiobook turns the conventional idea of competition on its head. It's not about how many people you can defeat, but rather about how many people you can help win. It will shake the foundation of the business community. While most companies box it out in the same old ring, Dan shows us that the key to winning is lifting one another up. Dan and his audiobook are definitive proof that collaboration is the only way to reach full potential as a business, as a professional, and even as a human being. The real-life case studies presented here help us internalize how this kind of collaboration really works. We all have a deep sense that collaborative environments deliver results. What we struggle with are ways to make collaboration a real and constructive thing in our organizations. The audiobook is the tool that helps business leaders quickly and easily jump into game-changing mode and prepare themselves to capture tomorrow's business opportunities. It is a real pleasure to see that Dan has captured a portion of his collaborative model and life experiences on paper for others to learn and grow from. His professional successes as an entrepreneur and leader in numerous organizations qualify him as an expert on the subject. As we have worked directly with Dan over the years, it's always been easy to leave each discussion motivated with a new perspective, renewed to try something innovative, and ready to face stubborn challenges. Now we've got the audiobook. Preface. I was doing a guest lecture for an MBA class a few years ago when a student asked what I thought was the most important building block to a company's success. My initial answer was people, finding great people. The student's facial reaction was probably a lot like mine when I was in business school and some gray-haired CEO said something just like that. People. What? I could tell by her expression that she thought it was an insincere answer, which it was not. She also asked what I thought was our company's competitive advantage, to which I responded, the people, process, and technology to create collaborative solutions. All the students' facial expressions were pretty similar. Collaboration? What? They brushed it off as a similarly insincere answer, which, again, it wasn't. That began my writing project. I am the CEO and founder of CaseStack, a full-service logistics company that offers warehousing, transportation, and an award-winning tech platform. We've been fortunate to win a lot of recognition over the years for being part of a select group with attributes including fastest-growing company, best place to work, best technology, greenest, and many more. And lots of people have been trying to figure out our secret sauce, so I thought I would try to take away the mystery. Collaboration is that sauce. If you are like many of the people we have worked with over the years, you too may have a quizzical look on your face upon hearing that word. Therein lies the reason for the audiobook. Too many quizzical looks on too many faces. That translates into too many lost opportunities. It's my hope that this audiobook makes my point. To put it in simple terms, collaboration is not some newfangled idea, but it very much is newly important and enabled because of cultural and economic changes that are occurring related to technology and globalization. For the most part, we've all grown up and been trained in one primary business interaction methodology, competition. Ironically, my premise is that you will crush your competition if you develop and have access to another tool, collaboration. Given that belief, it should come as no surprise that our company, CaseStack, is a successful experiment in collaboration. Ever since our founding in 1999, we have focused our efforts on collaboratively improving technology and customer-facing activities rather than making significant investments in buildings or trucks. More recently, even our hardware is cloud-based, that is, it resides on the web rather than on our physical premises. Our cloud-based technology has been recognized many times for its ease of use, security, and functionality. Many of our key business partners could easily be misconstrued as competitors, but they are actually our closest allies. Our warehouse partners have integrated with us to the point that we often feel like we are the same company, and each partner has the highest certifications available in the industry. Our people work in their facilities. Their people frequently use offices in ours. In addition, our most important service platforms have been developed with very large retailers who are not customers, vendors, or even partners in a legally documented sense. Rather, they are co-collaborators. We'll talk more about this, but for now, suffice it to say we all have these common goals: cutting costs, increasing efficiency, and improving service. All parties are doing what they are best at, and in aggregate, we are able to deliver at the lowest possible cost with the highest possible service quality. Through collaboration, we have built a completely non-asset-based company in a traditionally asset-heavy industry, and our growth has proven the concept successful. I hope that, in the chapters ahead, you will discover the nuances and power of collaboration. Work with us and each other, and win. Acknowledgement. I want to extend a special thanks to Susan Gilliland Collier for all of her help in contemplating and developing my thoughts about collaboration and its vast opportunities. Introduction. The world has not just turned upside down, it is turning every which way at an accelerating pace. Tom Peters, thriving on chaos. We usually look at business as a competitive game, a game like basketball, in which there is a winner and a loser. On a daily basis, business often feels like a war. One business lives and the other dies. Conquer, kill, and destroy your competitors. The Art of War by Sun Tzu is still considered timeless wisdom that applies as much to today's boardrooms as it did to a battle in the Chinese countryside back in the 6th century BC. Not to say there is anything wrong with competition, but experienced managers ought to have more than one tool in the toolbox. True leaders use different tools for different situations. They can be trusted to rise to the occasion, whatever it may be, and make it work. Michael Jordan put it this way: talent wins games, but teamwork and intelligence wins championships. Many view what has come to be called social Darwinism as a constant battle for survival, competition. Winners survive and losers disappear. But what that concept really describes is survival of the winner, rather than Herbert Spencer's survival of the fittest or Darwin's true theory of natural selection. It is the extreme competitors who interpret fittest to be those who compete and win. In the coming decades, there is a strong case to be made that the fittest will be the ones who know how to collaborate. Great collaborators, ironically, will be the best competitors. Collaboration with your customers, and sometimes even with apparent competitors, creates stronger businesses. Most important, collaboration often leads to the discovery of the biggest and best of innovations, the ones that address unknown latent opportunities. Think of the iPhone, Swiffer, Post-it notes, Netflix. While pure competitors are slugging it out, often anguishing over new ways to make the same mousetrap better, or ways to do the wrong things faster, better, and cheaper, there are collaborators in the wings actually innovating and finding solutions to problems many people didn't realize they even had. We aren't talking about hackneyed concepts of win-win, synergy, or 1+1=3. We're talking about what Robert Wright wrote about in his book Non-Zero, in which he shows that human culture has been evolving from tribes in barbaric competition to larger groups in civilized cooperation, moving toward more collaboration. According to Wright, in 1500 BC, there were 600,000 autonomous political entities in the world. In the year 2000, there were only 195. Wright points out that in early cultures, individuals, groups, tribes, chiefdoms, and states were constantly involved in zero-sum games. Nobody trusted anybody. Everybody assumed the worst about others. Fighting, treachery, slaughters, and wars were common. But we have managed to move beyond this to cooperation among towns, cities, counties, states, and many allied nations. Now, as Thomas Friedman so eloquently laid it out in his eponymous book, the world is flat, and we are moving at warp speed, together. The key point to know is this: competition and collaboration are tools or styles. Leaders must be prepared to use them at appropriate moments. In business school, everyone usually learns about the concept of situational management and situation leadership. That is, you don't succeed by always using the style you like the best. You use different management styles that are better suited to different situations, and you switch among them to maximize results. Similarly, the sole answer to all issues isn't always competition. Sometimes a situation calls for collaboration to generate the biggest bang for the buck. Seismic changes in technology, globalization, culture, and attitudes are occurring more quickly than ever. As we trek through our daily lives, it's difficult to go a day without being jolted by something dramatic that bumps up against our normal comfort zone. We run into new technology applications on a Friday that will change how we work on the following Monday. We see unraveling institutions that were so big that we did not comprehend that they could ever fail. We've begun to recognize that AAA-rated financial instruments can be revealed to be junk within days, and seemingly solid industries or even countries may really be on the brink of bankruptcy. And we see these global issues actually affecting our personal lives and our career paths. Technology is changing how humans interact. Wealth is being destroyed and created more rapidly than ever before. According to the U.S. Department of Labor, younger baby boomers held an average of 10.8 jobs from ages 18 to 42. Faced with all of this, many people are hunkering down, trying to get by in a new world that seems beset by increasing scarcity. But others are looking with curiosity at a new paradigm of the endless opportunities being created by collaboration. Google Trends will tell you that the word collaborate is in searches twice as much as it was a few years ago. As of this writing, a search on collaborate yields about 52 million results. A lot of people are intrigued by this new paradigm in human interaction and the vastness of the opportunities that it might present. Many are talking about collaboration. Some people are expounding the concept. Many think they are collaborating. Others are really succeeding in doing so. This audiobook is for those with the drive and intellectual curiosity to try to step out from that world of seeming scarcity, to embrace a new way of thinking that requires a new approach to reach success. It is to be listened to from beginning to end, starting with a description of collaboration, what it is and what it isn't. Then I discuss why now, more than ever, collaboration is doable and critical to success. There are examples of successes and failures to help listeners identify the concept and the reasons for its importance. The middle of the audiobook explains that although our traditional methodologies can be obstacles, we are each endowed with some natural collaborative instincts that we can find and put into action. The final part of the audiobook helps the listener understand the tactical requirements and use the tools to achieve collaborative success. Chapter 1. What collaboration is and isn't. None of us is as good as all of us. Ray Kroc. We have become accustomed to the idea of winning through fierce competition. Simple concept, if you do something better than someone else, you win their market share. You eat their lunch. Collaborating with competitors is outside of our comfort zone. It seems alien and self-defeating. It feels as if we are helping them beat us at our own game. We know successful competitors to be those who invest time, effort, and resources to win as big a piece of the pie as possible. The traditional wisdom holds that it is worth investing in these things to beat the competition, but the transaction costs of competing are high, higher than many realize. As traditional competitive business practices have evolved and spread deeper and wider throughout the world, and as new technology has made all competitors knowledgeable, there are diminishing marginal benefits available for the winners. The cost of stealing crumbs back and forth between competitors barely justifies the process as it whittles away at the small margin that does still exist. In many instances, collaboration will give us a greater return on our investment. When successful collaborators invest time, effort, and resources, they capture a piece of pie that didn't exist before. Of the 765 CEOs surveyed in the IBM Global CEO Study 2006, 75% of respondents ranked collaboration as a very important part of innovation. The study also found higher revenue growth was reported by companies that collaborated with external resources than by those who did not. IBM Global Business Services, 2006. All parties increase their chance of success when they work together to create value that has never before existed. The old way of thinking traps competitors in a futile effort to steal pieces of an ever-shrinking pie back and forth from each other. In the new way of thinking, collaborators are moving forward by working together to find ways to make the current pie larger, or even to make an entirely new pie. Collaboration is not a new buzzword to everyone. Over a decade ago, Disney and McDonald's mastered the art of business collaboration and cross-promotion. While waiting for Disney's release of a major new animated film, consumers of all ages knew that Happy Meal toys related to the movie, as well as cross-promotional ads, were on the way. The idea to form the relationship was brilliant and clearly a win-win for both organizations, because both companies are icons in America with built-in public goodwill. Although the Happy Meal probably needs another round of collaborative thought that involves advocacy groups, it still generates over $3 billion of annual revenue and represents about 20% of all McDonald's meals sold. Many companies do cross-promotion, but these two worked at a strategic level to attempt to increase each of their capabilities. They shared risks, rewards, and responsibilities by planning events before, during and after a movie release. In addition, they have used movie advertising to sell food and food ads to sell more movies. The same principles apply for businesses seeking to grow or be more efficient in their business practices. Print Place Blog, 2009. Muji, a Japanese retailer, recently teamed up with legendary toy manufacturer Lego to develop a product that adds an extra dimension to Lego toys. If all Muji did was make an add-on product that worked with Lego, that could possibly be considered cooperation. But collaboration requires a high level of strategic work that can yield bigger results. In this case, Muji and Lego collaborated in the creation of a new series of toys that combine Lego's plastic blocks with paper elements. The result? 4 play sets that feature a collection of redesigned Lego parts, paper, and hole-punching tools that allow the user to combine them. Animals, characters, and a number of other shapes can be created using the sets, or they can be customized with a little imagination and additional paper. Robinson, 2009. Consider the effect on the two brands. Muji is an award winner for its simplistic design work. It sells a lot of ready-to-assemble furniture in its stores and seeks a creative and family-oriented image. Lego's reputation for simplicity and family fun assembly complements the Muji brand. Lego reinforces its brand message that its designs are serious enough, yet simple enough, to be considered by a design leader like Muji. Meanwhile, the new product receives increased exposure and sales in over 180 Muji stores. Lego also collaborated with the UK shoe manufacturer Kickers to create a high-quality leather boot that is fun for children. This 2010 premium shoe collection uses the bright colors that typify the Lego brand. The rubber trim on the Velcro version is an exact copy of a Lego brick, so the child can attach an actual brick to the end of the straps, and a rubber floret is designed to be attached to the eyelets of the lace-up style. When the boots were first released, a free ticket to Legoland was included with each pair. And because Kickers is a stylish youth brand, created in 1968 in France, the association even gave Lego some panache. What collaboration is and what it isn't. Collaboration is one of the popular business buzzwords of the moment, and companies are jumping on the bandwagon. Are they falling short of real collaboration and its benefits? Collaboration is defined as the synergistic relationship formed when two or more entities working together produce something much greater than the sum of their individual abilities and contributions. Effective collaboration can produce better quality projects, make more efficient teams, create healthier environments, greatly increase productivity, and enable more growth in organizations than ever could have existed before the concentrated emphasis was placed on collaboration. The business that quickly adopts a culture of collaboration will emerge stronger and more profitable than its counterparts that try to delay implementation of the collaboration required by the new knowledge-based economy. As Michael Schrage puts it in his book, Shared Minds, collaboration is the process of shared creation. Two or more individuals with complementary skills interacting to create a shared understanding that none had previously possessed or could have come to on their own. In a collaboration, multiple parties with complementary skills share knowledge, talents, skills, information, risks, and resources to achieve a mutual goal that they could not have achieved separately. The outcome of a successful collaboration is something that did not exist before. The solution to a problem, new ideas, a new, higher level of products, services, or know-how. Collaboration is not a touchy-feely concept. It's very much a focused, structured process. To understand and master the power of collaboration, we need to be able to distinguish it from other, seemingly related forms of working with other people. Collaboration is more than simply sharing resources. We work with other people, but we do not collaborate when we simply post information about an upcoming visit by a prominent guest speaker, coordinate our activities with another agency to increase public awareness of a certain issue, or fund a university initiative for a river cleanup. Although networking, coordination, and cooperation, which all can be defined as different levels of resource sharing, offer certain benefits to at least one of the involved parties, each of them lacks one or more of the essential components of collaboration. Resource sharing, just part of working together. Resource sharing is a process that occurs at different stages of collaboration, but does not in itself qualify as collaboration. Simple resource sharing takes place when we offer another party knowledge or information. For example, a friend may ask your advice on how to set up a new stereo system in his home because you have recently set one up for yourself. A professor may post on her office door a list of internship opportunities that her students could benefit from. Your company may allow another company to use your database in exchange for having access to theirs. All these are examples of simple resource sharing. At the end of such exchange, your friend may have the stereo system working, the professor's students may gain hands-on experience from the internships, and your organization may achieve its goals thanks to having access to an additional database. Yet none of these activities involves working together toward a common goal. None of them amounts to collaboration. Apart from information and know-how, the resources in resource sharing can mean anything a business needs to operate. Business dictionary, no date. Financial resources, human capital, tangible resources, for example, equipment and technology, and intangible resources, for example, reputation and goodwill. Organizations and individuals engage in resource sharing for various reasons and with various goals in mind. Charity or altruistic reasons could be a factor. One could share resources with the intention of strengthening friendship or goodwill. Quid pro quo, or an exchange of tangible or intangible assets between parties, could also be a goal of resource sharing. What makes simple sharing of resources different from collaboration? Lack of teamwork and absence of a unifying goal are the most obvious factors. In some cases, such as in charitable or altruistic sharing or acts of sharing out of friendship, only one of the parties can expect tangible benefits. As a result, simple resource sharing may fail to enhance the capacity of both parties. Finally, those involved in simple resource sharing are often more interested in the process than in the outcome. By contrast, a key feature of collaboration is that it is result-oriented, not process-oriented. Hansen, 2009. To get a clearer picture, let's take a look at three forms of collective work that are related to collaboration, but in fact represent three levels of resource sharing. Himmelman, 1993. These levels are networking, coordination, and cooperation. Networking, a start. Networking is defined as the exchange of information or services among individuals, groups, or institutions, especially in order to cultivate productive business relationships. Merriam-Webster, no date. In simple terms, it is merely the act of sharing information for mutual benefit. Networking is a popular way of working with other people because it is relatively simple to do, and it promises mutual benefit to all involved. It is also the most informal and non-committal way of working with other people, compared to the three C's: coordination, cooperation, and collaboration. Networking is often the first step toward collaboration. Networking usually involves communicating and working with people who have interests similar to ours. For example, organizations and individuals concerned about the ethical aspect of pollution may decide to set up a mailing list to share new information and organize regular meetings to discuss the issue. A software developer may attend a large IT conference to evaluate market trends and see whether the project she has in mind could attract interest from big IT businesses. Networking is easy to do because we have a wide pool of potential networking activities at our disposal, ranging from talking with our neighbors to attending professional meetings and conferences. The Riley Guide, no date. In fact, we network every day. We are networking when we make new acquaintances at a party, chat with a local shopkeeper, join social clubs or religious groups, contribute to mailing lists and blogs, or post messages in chat rooms. Nearly everyone today, even outside of a business environment, is aware of the unequivocal benefits of networking. We often discover new ideas, business opportunities, or new ways of potential career development thanks to active networking. Networking is informal. It does not require official meetings and organizational involvement. It can be done over a dinner or a couple of drinks, and you can walk out of a networking event whenever you please. Networking is a non-committal activity. It is also an act of simple sharing of resources, not true collaboration. That said, networking is often a first step toward identifying a collaborative opportunity. Coordination, taking it to a higher level. More formal and somewhat more complex than networking, coordination means synchronization and integration of activities, responsibilities, and control to ensure the most efficient use of resources in order to achieve specified objectives. Business Dictionary. In simple terms, coordination requires that some action be taken and that there is a sharing of information for mutual benefit and to achieve a common goal. Coordination is an integral part of collaboration, but it cannot be a substitute for it. Because coordination is a way to achieve a specific purpose, it calls for a more organizational approach than networking. It requires a higher level of involvement and responsibility from its participants. Coordination is an important part of public awareness campaigns and grassroots movements, especially those that call for a certain action or demand specific changes in the status quo. For example, various groups and organizations working in an undeveloped country may decide to have an AIDS Awareness Week, showing educational films, giving out red ribbons, and organizing a marathon to draw people's attention to the issue. Parents and teachers in a small town may draft a schedule so that two adults always accompany children who walk to school in areas where the school bus does not run. Coordination is most successful when parties affected by the proposed changes can contribute to the discussion of those changes. This method of working with other people creates a wealth of ideas, ensures awareness of different views on the consequences of one's actions, and enables broader participation from various groups. It is effective in preventing duplication of efforts and helps to promote the common cause. However, despite offering the same goal for the parties involved, coordination falls short of collaboration. Distinct groups working toward the same cause usually walk away from the coordination process as distinct groups. All parties work independently from each other, merely doing so at the same time as the other groups. Their learning from each other is limited. Finally, contrast the best result of coordination, achieving a previously identified goal, with the best result of collaboration, attaining a new, higher level of products, services, or know-how. Cooperation, even more significant. Cooperation means a voluntary arrangement in which two or more entities engage in a mutually beneficial exchange instead of competing. Business Dictionary. In simple terms, it combines the attributes of coordination with the sharing of resources. Thus, in addition to exchanging knowledge and synchronizing or adapting activities to achieve a common goal, cooperation includes the additional element of sharing business resources other than information. As part of cooperation, we may share funding, training, employees, workspace, marketing, and legal advice. Himmelman, 1993. Franklin D. Roosevelt famously said, "Competition has been shown to be useful up to a certain point and no further, but cooperation, which is the thing we must strive for today, begins where competition leaves off." Although having a common goal is typical for cooperating parties, the degrees of their attachment to that goal may differ. Although crucial for one of the parties, a common project may be less important, or a mere issue of status, to the other party. Severi, no date. In this case, the latter party learns little from the experience and does not evolve. Cooperation, therefore, falls short of collaboration for the following reasons. Although both cooperating parties may achieve their common goal, they do not necessarily enhance each other's capacity. In addition, cooperating parties do not fully share risks, responsibilities, and rewards. In the case of collaboration, all available resources, as well as risks, responsibilities, and rewards, are fully shared. Consider this example. In 2006, two businessmen from Chicago developed a design contest website, crowdspring.com, which enables graphic designers to get input from the entire community. Steiner, 2009. The idea is simple. Companies and other potential clients offer to host a contest for the best logo, ad flyer, or business card design, and designers submit their work to this contest, at the same time critiquing the work of others and exchanging comments and feedback. Because all designers participating in the project share the same goal, namely to provide the client with the best logo, banner, or other design product, CrowdSpring may resemble a collaborative tool. However, it is not. One glance at the components of collaboration tells us the CrowdSpring model has more elements of competition than collaboration. Indeed, at the end of the day, the designers work independently and compete with each other for the prize, Collaboration, in contrast, is about working together as a team, building on each other's work, proposing and assessing new creative ideas, and communicating with each other in an open and respectful environment. Collaboration is about the common goal of the team, not individual goals of its members. The CaseStack collaboration experience, a case study. CaseStack is often broadly characterized as a technology-enabled supply chain business process outsourcing company, but most customers would describe it more specifically.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.